There are all kinds of different DC fuses on the market, and it can get kind of confusing and overwhelming when trying to decide, you know, which one is going to be best for what purpose and which fuse goes in what fuse location. So I've broken down the 8 most common fuse types that we typically see in DIY camper electrical systems. Welcome to EXPLORIST.life. My name is Nate, and I teach people how to build DIY campers. Let's get started. Now, before we get started, as I was looking up all the specs for these fuses to make this video, I was made aware that every single fuse manufacturer seems to have their own different line of specialty fuses. So I'm only going to be talking about the fuses and their specs that were the most common and not necessarily the specialty lines. But if you're trying to figure out what fuses to use for your own system that you might be designing, be sure to just look at the manufacturer's specifications for the fuses that you're using. The 3 figures that I'm going to be talking about with all these fuses are the maximum voltage that the fuse can handle, the amperage range that the fuses come in, so a range of, you know, 30 amps to 300 amps, anywhere in between there, and the AIC. And this one isn't commonly talked about, but it is the ampere interrupt capacity, which means that if a short circuit happens, the fuse can interrupt that many amps. So for example, a fuse that has an AIC of 1,000 amps, if there is more than 1,000 amps flowing across the fuse when a short circuit happens, the fuse might just weld itself together and the power will continue to flow. Whereas if the amps is under that number, then the fuse is going to blow and the power is absolutely going to stop. Now, let's get started with glass fuses, aka AGC fuses. These fuses have a maximum voltage of 32 volts or 250 volts, depending on the manufacturer that is making the glass fuse. It has an amperage of a maximum of 40, so it's on the smaller side of these fuses, but I typically only see these used in 5 amps or less. It has an AIC of 1,000 amps at 32 volts or 10,000 amps at 250 volts. So that's not particularly useful for our cases because it really just depends on which manufacturer it's being made by. That being said, I don't ever like add these to a system. These seem like they're always as part of another piece of equipment. For example, the power wire that feeds power to the Victron BMV712 or the smart shunt. It has one of these fuses pre-built into that power wire that comes from Victron. Next up is going to be a blade fuse. And I know anybody who's driven a vehicle has seen these. These are the ones that you typically, or the vehicle manufacturer puts in the OEM fuse block. They have a max voltage, most of the time, of 32 volts. They have an amperage rating of anywhere from 1 amp up to 40 amps. And they have an AIC of 1,000 amps at 32 volts. So like I said, OEM equipment under the dash in your vehicle, but also these are the same fuses that we use in our DC fuse panel that feeds all the branch circuits around a camper, like lights, max air fans, water pumps, anything like that, any of our small DC branch circuits. Next up are MAXI fuses. Now MAXI fuses, they look pretty much just like a big blade fuse, which that's realistically all they are. They have a max voltage of 32 volts normally, but there are 58 volt versions available. They have amperage ratings of usually from 20 amps to 80 amps, so a little bit bigger fuse, a little bit higher amp capacity, but their AIC is going to be the same as the blade fuses. Now, I don't really ever put these in any of the Explorist Life electrical systems. Sometimes you'll see these in OEM vehicle equipment and stuff like that, but that's what they are in case you run across them. Next up is MIDI fuses. MIDI fuses are a bolt-down fuse, so it gets a fuse holder or gets bolted to a bus bar. We typically see these in Mercedes Sprinters underneath the driver's seat where we make the connection for the Orion DC to DC charger. So that's gonna be a MIDI fuse. Those are typically 32 volts, but there are also 70 volt versions available. They come in amperage ratings from 30 amps all the way up to 200 amps. They have an AIC of 2,000 amps. Next are MRBF fuses, aka terminal fuses. And these are very, very versatile fuses. They can be bolted to a battery bank for main system battery protection. They can be bolted to the end of a Victronlinx distributor for a few extra spaces, which I've done a tutorial over showing you how to do that, that we'll link in the video description below. And these are great fuses. They have a maximum voltage of 58 volts, so they're going to be good for 12 volt, 24 volt, 48 volt battery banks. They have amperage ratings of anywhere from 30 amps to 300 amps, so a little bit bigger fuse. Their AIC is 10,000, which is fantastic because you can use these in pretty much any main fuse between the battery bank and the rest of the system. So even with a lithium battery, if you direct short a lithium battery, it's going to flow a lot of amps. And all of the fuses we've talked about so far probably would not be able to break the flow of power if you short circuit a lithium battery. And an MRBF fuse, depending on the size of the lithium battery, is going to be able to stop that flow of power. So we use these anytime that there's going to be a lot of power flowing and the amperage rating can be less than, can be 300 amps or less. Mega fuses are what we use the most of because that's what fits inside of the Victronlinx distributor. We use the mega fuses to protect the wires going to our multi-plus inverter chargers, our DC to DC chargers, solar charge controllers, DC fuse blocks, anything like that. Anything that connects to the Victronlinx distributor is getting a mega fuse. The most common ones are rated for 32 volts, but there are 58 volt versions available. They are rated from amperages of 60 amps all the way up to 500 amps. They only have an AIC rating of 2000 though, so they aren't particularly good at putting in between the battery bank and everything else in the rest of the system, especially on a lithium battery bank. There's just better options for that. Next up is ANL fuses. And these fuses are what we use between our battery banks and the rest of our system as of today. They have a voltage of 32 volts, although there is a 80 volt version available. And they have an amp rating of anywhere from 50 amps all the way up to 750 amps. So they can handle a lot of current. Now their AIC is 6,000. So actually just a little bit less than an MRBF fuse, but we're going to use the ANL fuse anytime that we would be using the MRBF fuse for main system protection, except where we may need a 400 amp fuse like we have in the majority of our systems that have the 12 volt version of the MultiPlus 3K inverter charger in it. And the last one is a Class T fuse. And the Class T fuse would realistically be used in the exact same manner and places as an ANL fuse. Let's get into the stats of this one and I'll explain why I say usually. So Class T fuses have a voltage of 125 volts. That's a max voltage. They have an amperage range of 110 amps to 400 amps or so. The AIC on these is 20,000. So this is the highest AIC rating of any of the fuses that we've talked about. Now this makes it an absolutely perfect candidate for the fuse in between the battery bank and the rest of the system. But we use ANL fuses in our system. And here's why. Class T fuses for the last 3 years or so have ultimately been unavailable. They are the best option for fusing in between the battery bank and the rest of the system, but how useful is something whenever we can't get it? Steph was looking the other day for Class T fuses, and apparently there's going to be about 58 Class T fuses in the US later this year that we as Americans just get to share, apparently. So ultimately it's not that useful. But as soon as we have Class T fuses available to us, I will be swapping those in to our diagrams and our systems and our kits in place of the ANL fuses. But ultimately, until those are available, we have to go with the next best option, which is the ANL fuses. And those are the 8 most common DC fuses that we see in camper electrical systems. Now, if you don't want to have to go through all of this and figure out what fuses that you need to use for various places in your camper electrical system, you should check out our store, shop.explorist.life, where we have all the fuses, but more importantly, all the kits, so you don't really even have to think about all this. We'll see you next time.